Let us say we have two numbers n1, let's say 5, and n2, 0. If I divide any number by 0, that is 5 by 0, in mathematics such kind of expressions are actually not defined. Even if you do something like this, that is 0 divided by 0, even this is not defined. That means any real number, if you divide by 0, that is not defined in mathematics, right? So let us see in program how it is going to work. So for these variables n1 and n2, I'll take the data type as int. Now I'll print out the statement, that is n1 divided by n2. So this is the division operator. Now let's run this program. Let's see what happens. So you can see that exception in thread main, that is arithmetic exception. So it says that division by zero error. So this is your exception that is generated by Java. So it says that division of numbers by zero, any real number by zero, is not possible, right? Even if I use here double data type, still you will get the same result, right? That is, any real number by zero is actually, so here we get infinity, right? So it says that it's not defined. So here in Java, actually this not defined is denoted by this infinity, but actually in mathematics it is not defined. But when I'm using this int type, then there is an exception, right? You see, when I'm using this integer data type, it throws an exception. That means we cannot divide a number by zero. Now how to handle such cases? So for that, Java have exception handling mechanism that we shall learn later, but for now we can use if statement. So let me write here the result first of all. Integer result equals, or let me just write the if part here. If n2 equals 0, that means if the second number, that is your divisor, is 0, then let me generate a appropriate result. So I can just say here not defined. So now if I run this, the answer will be your not defined. And now if this n2 is, let's say, some other number, let's say 3, now your this if part will not get executed, right? So there will be no output in this program now. So this is how you can handle some small cases like this, right? Now let us write a program which can find the absolute value of a real number. So what is the meaning of this absolute value of a real number? Let's say x is a real number. It can be any number, let's say 9. So the absolute value of this real number x will be 9 as it is. So in short, in one line, if I say, if you give any number in this function of absolute, let's say this is an absolute function f of x, if you give any number to this, it will always give the positive number or 0. Let's say if your input to x is 0, then the output will be 0. If you give any positive number like 9, then the output is going to be 9. And if you give a negative number, then it will convert the negative into positive. So this absolute value function converts every negative number to positive. That means it always gives the absolute value of a number, right? So for positive numbers, the number is going to be positive as it is, and for negative numbers, it is going to be converted into positive, and for 0, it will exactly give 0 as it is, because 0 is neither positive nor negative, right? So just pause the video and try to write the code for this. Alright, assuming that you have tried for writing the code for this particular program, now let's see how can we write the code for this. So for that, I'll be taking the variable x. Since it's a real number, so I will take the data type as double. Now I'll give the message to the user, enter x, and in this x I'll read the value of this variable from the user input. So for that I'll be using in.nextDouble, right? So this line, this particular method nextDouble will help me to read the input from the keyboard, right? Now I'll be writing the condition here. If the number is negative, that is if x is less than 0, then I'll print out the statement as minus x. That is, if the number is negative, and if I multiply minus 1, right, if I multiply minus 1 into x, then the number is going to get converted into पॉजिटिव, राइट? सो इधर यू राइट माइनस वन इंटू एक्स और यू राइट सिंपली माइनस एक्स, बोथ आर सेम, राइट? नाउ इन द एल्स पार्ट, इन द एल्स पार्ट आई विल जस्ट प्रिंट आउट द एक्स एज इट इज. सो लेट्स रन दिस प्रोग्राम एंड लेट अस सी व्हाट हैपेंस. सो इफ आई रन इट, लेट मी एंटर ए पॉजिटिव नंबर दैट इज सेवन. सो द आउटपुट इज सेवन. लेट मी गिव द मैसेज प्रॉपरली हियर, एब्सोल्यूट वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. सो लेट मी राइट हियर एब्सोल्यूट वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स एंड देन आई विल अटैच दिस विथ माई वेरिएबल एक्स. सो फॉर दैट आई विल बी यूजिंग दिस प्लस साइन एंड इन दिस केस आई विल बी राइटिंग माइनस एक्स हियर एज इट इज. दिस इज द एब्सोल्यूट वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. सो लेट मी यूज दिस पैरेंथेसिस. नाउ इफ आई रन दिस, so enter the value of x. Let me enter a positive number that is 6 and if I hit enter, it says absolute value of x is 6.0, right? That's a real number. If I run it again and this time I give a negative number, let's say minus 9. So see, now this minus 9 is converted into positive 9, right? And the last input that we'll be giving, that is 0. Let us see it works for 0 or not. So if I hit 0, it gives the answer 0. So this is the program that is working completely fine to give the absolute value of a number. So in this program we saw that how can we deal with small cases like whenever your divisor is zero, how can we use if else to handle such kind of cases, and we also saw the program to find the absolute value of a number. Thank you for watching.